Call of the Himalayas is about setting yourself a goal that is very challenging, but ultimately going to be very satisfying for you to achieve, very important for you to achieve, and finding the way to actually then achieve it. Right from the beginning, I knew it was about striving to be the very best that you can, or a person can, in a particular field. It didn't really matter what the field was. And often when I'm writing about intangibles like that, I need something visual to help direct me, I guess, is the way I'd put it. And so in this case, I wanted to choose something that was majestic, large, and somewhat daunting. And so that's where the Himalayas idea came in. The people who feel drawn to the majestic mountains of the Himalayas often talk about a calling that lures them to their incredible adventures. People can also experience a calling to become the best version of themselves. This involves a person producing the best results that they are capable of within their chosen field. In order that you can rise to a significant challenge such as this, you have to be able to see what your goal is first. In other words, you need to have a clear idea about what it is that you're seeking to achieve. So Númenor is a large island which features in the fictional writings of J.R. Tolkien. And what fascinated me about this island is that on it is a society which changed very quickly from a harmonious society to one in which there was a lot of turmoil and friction. And I found that contrast quite interesting, and to then explore how I could describe that in music. The story of Númenor describes how quickly a society can change from being a harmonious and peaceful one to one of immense turmoil and destruction. This piece of music opens with material describing the dramatic turmoil, and then retrospectively takes a look back at the peaceful times that preceded this drama, before returning to the turmoil which ultimately leads to the destruction of the island.